Time to do some research.
Hello? Greetings.
It's a good day for battle. The battle is truly joy. Out of my way! The battle is truly joy. Now then. Death by a thousand cuts! Is unbending! I wreak havoc upon thee! Now then! Out of my way! Have at you! I obey his Windhild, fight with us! With each battle, I grow stronger.
Hello there. Thank you.
I see. What have we here? Aha! Not bad. A passing grade. Aha!
this place.
You should have studied harder.
No.
Professor, you truly are every bit as brilliant as Olduvan said.
I did not come here for false flattery.
Oh, but I was being quite sincere. A shame the purport eludes your grasp.
To think you were the one pulling the strings. The headmaster was merely your puppet all along.
Very astute. Yes, it was I who maneuvered to install him in that position in the first place. To my dismay, he had a willful streak that got in the way.
One might say the fault lies in the person who chose him for the task.
One might say that, yes. Now, let us proceed to the matter at hand. Your search for the original copy of From the Far Reaches of Hell has miraculously led you to me. In finding me, you have displayed some measure of knowledge and acumen. More than any, you have shown a pure and unrelenting passion for seeking out the truth. I hold that particular quality in the highest regard. What say you, Silas? Will you join me in my research?
Ridiculous! If that is a jape, it is a poor one.
A jape? What a curious reaction from a scholar like yourself. The wall paintings in this place, did they not pique your interest? Did your heart not race when you saw the countless lost tomes in my study?
To say I was not intrigued would be a lie.
Of course you were. Yes, any true scholar would feel the same. I must unravel these mysteries. I must have the answers. Your mind, no, your very soul burns with an all-consuming desire to know. That is what separates you from the rest, Cyrus. We are true seekers of knowledge, you and I. Together. We can unlock all the secrets behind our world.
I'll pass.
How can you refuse? You covet the mysteries of the universe. You yearn to know the truth. Surely you can stand shoulder to shoulder with me.
That's it exactly.
What? What is it?
Surely you. I take issue with your solicitation. You don't care who you use in your schemes. What of Headmaster Yvonne?
Don't be ridiculous. He was devoid of the passion you have. He was nothing but a pawn to the end, incapable of envisioning an ultimate goal.
On what grounds do you base that assumption? Can a man not grow his mind? If you found him wanting, why did you not teach him?
Teach him?
take him on as your pupil. Impart your vast knowledge, that he might one day be your peer.
Preposterous. You speak the impossible. Mediocrity is as mediocrity does. Knowledgeable as he was, his own actions prevented him from ever approaching genius. A genius such as yourself must understand this.
There's where you and I differ. I haven't given up on mediocrity. As scholars, we learn from the past to better understand the present and pass our knowledge on to the future. What do you mean to do with the knowledge you amass? The secrets you unravel? Carry them to your grave, content they are inscrutable to all who do not possess your genius. You would call them simpletons, fools, feeble minds. I say it is you who lacks the ability to teach and inspire. A true scholar does not look down on others for what they do or do not know. Those who know impart knowledge to those who do not. If something is wrong, those who know the answer correct it. The process repeats, bringing us closer and closer to enlightenment. I teach my students with the expectation that one day they will surpass me. I long for the day when I will have the chance to learn from them.
Enough! I've given you plenty of opportunities to make a move. Any move. But clearly we are going nowhere fast. If you would rather die without discovering the truth, so be it. I have already synthesized a perfect blood crystal, precisely as detailed in the original tome. With it, I will cast off the shackles of humanity. A human can only learn so much in its short lifetime. I will gain the time, the power, to understand everything. You may be a fool, but to show no hard feelings, you can participate in an empirical analysis of my newfound power.
If believing in the future makes one a fool, then call me a proud fool. But know this. When I emerge victorious, I will unravel the secrets of that tome and arrive at my own answer. Let this be a lesson to you. The future of mankind is bright. I cannot fail.
I am ready. Gentlemen.
Victory shall be mine. Come, if you dare.
I'll not be defeated. Trust in your aid.
Now, what next? A gift for you.
I am ready. Be gentle.
Now then! The dawn fights on!
Curse witchery!
My turn now!
Victory shall be mine! Death by a thousand cuts!
An interesting dilemma.
Ah!
A gift for you.
I am ready. Stay strong.
Well then. Have this.
I am ready.
Watch out! I'll do my best.
Have at you. The dawn fights on.
What is the logical course of action? How about this?
I am ready.
Victory shall be mine! The dawn fights on!
I'll not be defeated. Bring about a miracle of healing.
I am ready. Stay strong.
Now then!
My focus is unparalleled!
elemental trick!
Well then.
The peacock struck.
Now, what next?
Now the true lesson begins! Lux Conjurer!
I'll not be defeated!
Victory shall be mine!
You like that?
The battle is truly joy. Have a taste of this!
An interesting dilemma.
Lux Conjurer!
No! There is so much more I must learn.
A hole. Now then! No. But of course! But of course! Indeed! Indeed. Not exactly. Thusly. Yes.
Professor! Professor!
Over here, Therese.
That stack of books seems to get bigger every time I see you.
And I'll need twice again as many to have any hope of translating this ancient tome.
Twice as many?
Fascinating, is it not? A traditional fairy tale from a certain region mentioned a gate of sorts. And I could not help but notice a parallel to the mural I found.
I see. Hence, these books on local folklore?
Just so. Considering your subject from all possible angles is a fundamental principle of scholarly research. But I forget myself. Might I surmise that you've come here to inform me that it's time for class?
Yes. You're late, Professor.
Pray forgive me, Your Highness. Very well then, my students. Let us begin. To quote the words of one Susanna Grotoff, author of Knowledge is Light. The pursuit of knowledge is a journey with no destination. As long as people live, there is always something to learn. And so we learn, we record, we speak. Points connect, thus forming our history, our agency, our identity. This world we live in is not for or of any one individual, and neither is knowledge. And so I write and speak of all that I learned to plant seeds of knowledge that will be harvested by those who follow me. To you who have found my writings, read well these words, that they may help you build a bridge to a brighter future.